Friday the 13th, the game. Is it worth a buy, guys? Is it worth it? Is it worth your f***ing money? Well, let's read the words of the developer, and then I'll tell you what I think. Yeah. Jason is back. Jason Voorhees is unleashed and stalking the grounds of Camp Crystal Lake. Friday the 13th, the game, is one of the most highly anticipated horror titles of all time.
Who wrote this f***ing... What? Of all f***ing time? Are you actually f***ing...
You will finally be able to take on the role of Jason Voorhees and Camp Crystal Lake counsellors.
Well, I'll tell you what it isn't, guys. It's not one of the most highly anticipated horror titles of all time. It's just... no. It's not even... It's hardly... So what do you do? Well, basically, if you've played Dead by Daylight, then you've pretty much played this... Except you'll be £15 more out of pocket, because this costs £30, that costs £15. And basically what it is, it's a hide-and-seek simulator. It is. It's with some bad animations. That's what this game is. So where do we start? Well, we'll start with the fact that it's multiplayer only. And a bit laggy. And the population's full of Russians for some reason. I don't know why that is. It must be really popular in Russia, but every game has just been full of The gameplay revolves around Jason trying to murder 7 counselors, and the counselors all have different kind of stats. You level up through the game and you can unlock more counselors who have better stats as you go along. Basically, the stats are kind of stealthy stats, repairy stats, level-headedy stats, strengthy stats, sprinty stats, slowy stats, screamy stats, you know, that kind of stuff. And it is very important. It is very important that you know what you're doing when you choose your counsellor, as I have found out to my f***ing peril so many times with bellends who don't know what they're doing. Jason, on the other hand, he is just a wrecking machine who has... amazing abilities, guys. This game is for the 2017 game. If you're a 2017 gamer and you masturbate over AAA titles and all the shite that comes with them, you're going to love this, because I'll tell you what it's got. It's got teleportation. You can teleport as Jason Voorhees around the map anywhere you want instantly. It is on a cooldown. All of these powers I'm going to tell you about now are on a cooldown. But he can teleport around the map. Just, oh yeah, I'll go over there because I think there's somebody trying to repair a phone. I'll teleport there. Ah, there you are. Bang, you're dead. He can also see through walls with his senses vision. So there is no hiding from Jason at all. You just can't hide from Jason. You can delay him, but you can't hide. He can see you anywhere you want. And if you do elude him in a house and he goes in and you dive out the window so you get a few seconds on him and you're about 100 yards away, that's not going to help you. Because Jason has the Usain Bolt ability, where he actually goes faster than Usain Bolt without actually running, because he levitates and just goes flying around the fucking map like a prick at about 100 miles an hour. And as he goes flying past you, he just... presses the right mouse button and he will grab you by the throat and choke you to death. And if you think that's bad enough, he also has like an invisibility mode, which is basically when Jason's, the music goes, that sounded more like a monkey running away from a hunter and then getting shot up the arse with a load of buckshot. But basically the music comes in when Jason's near you and you get the old VHS tracking's gone out, you know, trying to make it look 80s. But Jason has this stealth ability which will disable all that music, so you don't know that he's right next to you because the music's all good. La, la, de, 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 de. But Jason's actually right behind you sharpening his machete, so he has that as well. Now, the counselors have some amazing weapons. They have the penknife of Rathron, which is a really sacred... well, it's just a normal penknife, actually. But you would think it was some kind of sacred relic. Because if you find this little tiny penknife with a 2-inch fucking blade and have that on you, when Jason comes up to you, this pretty much indestructible 7-foot-high monster built like a brick fucking shithouse, when he picks you up, you pull out your little 2-inch penknife blade and stab it in his neck. And Jason goes, oh, and drops you, and he's paralyzed the 30 fucking seconds because of a fucking 2-inch penknife, you fucking stupid. You also have a shotgun with one bullet in it, which is very, very lethal. You also have traps, bear traps, but so does Jason. You have axes, pipes, planks, machetes, pans, you name it, anything you can pick up and hit it with. And this is where the actual stats of the counselors come in, because some of the counselors have this luck ability and a bit of strength, and they can hit Jason and stun him. And you can get perks as well that you can put in, which will stack and increase these abilities, such as stealth and stun and speed and all of that lot. So you have to be careful when you choose your character that you know exactly how to play him, because the map has a number of things on it. It has a few cars, a motorboat, a telephone, a radio, and these are all ways to escape Jason. For example, the cars need a battery, they need fuel, and you need to find the keys. They're all hidden randomly around the map. They spawn in random places every game. And when you find one of the items, say the battery, you take it to the car and you install it, which is a mini game which revolves around this little wheel going faster and faster around, giving you commands to do, like press your left mouse button, press your right mouse button, left mouse button, right mouse button. But if you don't have a character that has much repair skill, that wheel will go around very fast and the time you get to press your button will be very short, so the chances are you're gonna fail. And when you fail, you emit a noise that Jason can detect and teleport pretty much straight to that point and kill you. So basically, the people who have the expert repair should be the ones installing the batteries, filling the cars up, putting the propellers on the boats, repairing the phones and things like that. They have, you see, usually really good stealth. The problem with them lot is, though, they can't run very fast. So me, I play this stealthy bitch who can't run fast but is pretty much undetectable, because when you run or sprint or jog or anything in this game, you make a little sound wave that Jason can see. But the stealthy ones don't. They don't make any noise at all. So you can go and get a battery, take it to the car, install it pretty much silently. The problem is, people are so fucking shite at games, they will pick characters that make a lot of noise, and they'll fucking follow you around like a fucking lapdog. Alright Mac, I'll come with you. Alright Mac, I'll come with you and protect you with this bat. And I'm saying, get the fuck away from me, you're giving away me fucking position. You're making more noise than a fucking fat man in a cake shop. Just fuck off, will ya? Just go the fuck away. And then I'll come with you. And so Jason comes because he sees all the fucking racket that Mr. fucking No Brains is doing, and he sees me and says, oh, I can easily catch you because you can't fucking run. The guy who's made all the noise, he's fast, so he fucks off, and I'm left there with a fucking battery going at about the speed of a one-legged fucking hippo, and he just comes up and he whacks us with his machete and kills us, and I'm going, you stupid. So basically, guys, what I'm trying to say is make sure you actually know how to play the game before you go and ruin everybody else's. And so that's pretty much how the game works. You can ring the police if you fix the radio, and then you've got to survive till the police come, then run to the police cars, which are at basic exits around the map. You can repair the car, fuel it up, find the keys, get in the car, drive off the map, or you can just wait till the map timer runs out if you can survive. That's how you can win as a counselor. As Jason, you've got to kill everybody, of course. Now, there's also other things. I'll tell you a few tips if you want, because they're relevant to people who might want to buy this game. If you remember, Jason has this shack and he has this shrine dedicated to his mother. And she has, I think it was in Friday the 13th, part 2, where somebody stole Jason's mother's clothes and put them on, and she was able to subdue Jason because Jason thought it was his mother. You can actually do that in this game, and that's how you can actually kill Jason. But there's a few things that you have to do to be able to do that. I've never been able to do it in the games that I've played, but I have escaped, and I've also been Jason and people from escaping. So it is quite fun. Some of the things that happen are really fun. For example, I had a gun, and I was near an exit point, and I just happened to look at the map, and I noticed my comrades had fixed the car up and were actually driving the car round to come out of the map. And so I was near the road that they were going to exit from, so I got myself in a position where I would be able to run in front of the car. Hopefully they would stop and they would actually let me get in, and we'd drive off and win. The problem was, Jason knew this as well. And so as I was running towards the road, I noticed Jason contact Scotty on the Starship Enterprise, who teleported him right into the path of the car. Now, the car driver couldn't see Jason yet because he was still about 100 yards away. So what I knew I had to do was stop Jason from smashing the car up, because he would have with his axe, and then we would all be f***ed. So I ran towards Jason at the same time the car was flying towards Jason. He got to the front of the car and was just about to axe it, and I fired my shotgun. I hit him, and it staggered him and dazed him for 30 seconds. The car then drove off. I'm running after the car like a daft git, and the guy must have thought, stop, 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 let's help him, he saved our lives. So the car stopped. I run to get in the door. I open the door. I'm just sitting in, big smile on my face. Then f***ing Jason just grabs me, doesn't he, and pulls me out and kills us. And it was so good. It was like the ending of a movie. It was really good, but... you know, I found that most of the games don't end quite as nice as that. They are pretty boring. It's just hiding around the house. It is clunky as f***. The amount of times I've opened the door to go into a building and then shut it before I've actually gone in the building. It is clunky as f***. The hitboxes are hideous. I'm quite sure I've missed loads of times when I've been swinging my axe, but I've actually hit. It's so clunky, just trying to line up your key with something to pick up, waiting for the prompt to say press E to pick it up. And the reason it says press E on mine is because you can't rebind the fucking keys. Let's have a look at the options. There's the options for you guys. You literally can't rebind a single fucking key in a £30 fucking game. I mean, what the fuck is wrong with that? I don't use WSAD. Loads of people don't use. We don't all use fucking WSAD. Basically, guys, it is a console reeking game. This is built for console players. It's built for consoles. PC's an afterthought. It's just that, oh, give them that version. Just give them any old. The fobs like my arsehole. It's just awful, guys. It's just it's clunky shit, basically, as far as the PC version is concerned. It needs love, which we probably won't get, guys. We probably won't get on the PC. It needs a lot of work. It needs a lot of work. Get rid of third person. It should be... I'm not going to have this argument because, guys, you know what? Where I stand on third person games. Sitting there. I was sitting there looking for Jason. He couldn't see me, but I could see him. I was just peeping around the corners. Unless he uses X-ray vision, of course. It's full of the stuff that I consider cheating. This game's full of the features now, guys, because it's 2017. So there you go, guys. That's Friday the 13th. Is it worth a buy? Not at £30, it isn't. Not when Dead by Daylight's only f***ing 15. You know what I'm saying? Nomse.
Don't stop, Jason. They deserve to die. Make them suffer like we did.